Next question comes from Jay, who's asked, can you change rod bearings and crank with new bearings after a spun bearing without splitting the engine and removing pistons, etc.? If you have any real level of bearing damage at all, you're going to have a lot more work on your hands than just replacing the bearing shells. So particularly if a bearing has spun, that's going to also damage the journal of the either the engine block or the conrod that that particular bearing was in. So you're going to need quite a lot of corrective machine work in order to fix that. In some instances, the conrod particularly will be a throwaway item. It's going to probably be exposed to a huge amount of heat, and it's quite often in those situations you're going to see the surface of the conrod will be either blue or black from the heat it's been exposed to, due simply to the friction. So yeah, if you've got bearing problems like this, you're very, very seldom going to be able to get away with just fitting new bearings. The other thing you need to understand though as well, and this is a common mistake I see people make, when we've got a problem, it's not enough just to fix the symptoms of that problem. What we really need to do is dig a little bit deeper and find out why did that problem happen in the first place, because otherwise we're just opening ourselves up to have exactly that same issue again.
That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.